tao.
Yes, go ahead.
Dapong sa lahat. Halos tatlong buwan na po ang nakalipas mula nang nasawi si Jesse Robredo. Isang bansa tayong nagluksa sa kanyang pagkawala at isang bansa tayong nagbuhos ng pakikiramay at suporta hindi lamang kina Lenny at sa kanilang tatlong anak, kundi maging sa lahat ng umasa, nagtiwala, humanga at naiwan ni Jesse. Bahagi ng pagbabalik-tanaw natin sa mga alaala at pamana ni Jesse ay ang pagbibigay linaw sa tunay na nangyari sa pagbagsak ng sinasakyan nilang eroplano. Gayun din ang paniniguro na managot ang sinumang may kakulangan at sangkot sa trahedyang ito. Isang komiteng binubuo ng mga dalubhasa mula sa aviation industry ang itinalaga natin upang mag-imbestiga, maglikom ng testimonya, magsiyasat ng mga ebidensya at maghain ng mga rekomendasyon ukol dito. Nauna po nating mabasa ang inisyal na resulta ng investigasyon, magkahalong lungkot at pagkadismaya po ang ating naramdaman. Iisa po kasi ang itinuturo ng mga ebidensya. Kung tama lang ang ginawa ng ilang tao, kung sinunod lang ang mga patakaran ng industriya, kung nanatili lang na matapat sa kanilang obligasyon ang ilang sangkot, tsak pong naiwasan dapat ang nangyaring trahedya. Nais ko lang pong linawin, hindi po pagbabatuhang sisi ang gusto nating gawin. Hagat natin ay katarungan, hindi lang para kay Jesse, kundi maging sa iba pang nasawi. Hagat natin ay maiwasan na maulit ang ganitong pangyayari. Ito po ang resulta ng investigasyon. Bagaman marami ang nagsasabing ekspertong piloto, si Kapitan Jessup M. Bainting, wala siyang angkop na karanasan at kasanayan sa one engine in operative emergency. Malinaw ito nang nabigo niyang panatilihin ang ligtas sa paglipad ng eroplano nang iisang makina na lamang ang gumagana. Bukod dito, 23 minuto matapos silang mag-takeoff sa Mactan, batid na ng piloto na palyado ang kanilang makina. Subalit sa halip na bumalik, tumulak pa rin sila sa Naga. Inabot pa sila ng 70 minuto sa impapawid bago ang kanilang pagbagsak. Ibig sabihin, kung agad silang bumalik sa Mactan, mataas ang posibilidad na naiwasan ang aksidente. Pangalawa, taliwas sa Piper Seneca Flight Manual Procedures for Twin Engine Planes ang pagbababa niya ng landing gear at flaps kahit na hindi tiyak kung aabot sila sa runway ng Masbate. Ayon sa mga eksperto, dumagdag ito sa drag na siyang nagpabagal sa eroplano hanggang sa hindi na ito makontrol at tuluyang bumagsak. Lalawan rin ang kakulangan ng checks and balances ang Aviatours. Napatunayan sa investigasyon na mismo mga mekaniko ng Aviatours ang nagkukumpuni ng Piper Seneca, gayong hindi naman sila otorisado na manufacturer na magsagawa ng maintenance sa nasabing eroplano. Dahil sa patong-patong at pare-parehong tungkulin ng kanilang mga opisyal, nagkakaroon ng conflict of interest, kaya hindi nabibigyan ng tamang atensyon ang ligtas na kondisyon ng eroplano. Base sa ilang papeles na nalikom ng investigation panel, sangkot rin di umano sa kunsyabahan ang Aviatours at isang inspector ng CAAP sa tahasang paglabag sa mga regulatory requirements. Nobyembre 2011, nang pinalitan ang right-hand engine propeller ng bumagsak na Piper Seneca de Mano. Upang matiyak na ligtas sa paglipad ng eroplano, nag-file ng propeller overhaul report si Ginoong Nelson Napata, ang Director for Maintenance ng Aviatours noong Enero. Nagad namang inaprobahan ng CAAP Airworthiness Inspector na si Ginoong Fernando Abalos. Ayon sa aircraft test flight report ng CAAP, nabigyan ng test flight clearance, inabot ng isang oras ang test flight at satisfactory ang kondisyon ng Piper Seneca. Subalit, ayon sa isinagawang investigasyon, walang record sa aircraft logbook ang nasabing test flight. Wala ring nakatalang flight plan dito ayon sa Mactan International Airport. Malinaw po ang ginawa nilang panlilinlang at pandaraya. Ang naging kabayaran, buhay ng tatlong tao. Sintomas po ito sa paglaganap ng katiwalaan sa isang sistemang matagal na umiiral na isinasaayos na ngayon ng pamahalaan. Hindi po tayo papayag na manatili ang ganitong kalakaran. Kaya naman patuloy po ang paglilikom na iba pang ebidensya upang mapanagot ang sinumang may pagkukulang sa panig ng Aviatours at maging ng CAAP. Kaugnay nito, inatasan na natin ang DOTC at ang mga bagong mas pinatibay na pamunuan ng CAAP. Gayun din ang ilang katuwang na ahensya upang ipagpatuloy na palakasin at pabilisin ang mga inalalatag nating reforma sa aviation industry. Lahat po ng permit at lisensyang inaprubahan ng CAAP, muli nating pinapa-audit at kung may makita tayong dumaan sa shortcut at lumabag sa mga nakasaad sa Philippine Civil Air Regulations, agad po nating babawiin. Muli rin po nating sinusuri at pinapatibay ang mga alituntunin sa pagpapatakbo ng mga flying schools, air taxi, approved maintenance organizations at iba pang grupo na may kaugnayan sa industriyang panghimpapawid sa bansa. Nais nating matiyak na kung hindi ka kwalipikado, hindi ka mabibigyan ng lisensya. Bukod sa pagbuo ng mga pamantayan na magagamit para sa mas epektibong crash rescue operations, inaasahan din natin ang DOTC at CAAP na magpanday ng mga karagdagang mekanismo upang mas maigpit na maipatupad ang mga regulasyon ng industriya. Mulat din tayong nakasalalay ang kaligtasan ng ating mga pasero, hindi lamang sa modernisasyon ng ating air navigation systems, kundi maging sa uri ng pamunuan ng mga kasiwa sa CAAP. Obligasyon ng pamunuan ng CAAP na tiyaking may kakayahan at may integridad ang kanilang tauhan. Susuportahan natin sila dito, gayon din sa iba pa nating nilang layunin at pangangailangan tungo sa mas matatag at mas ligtas na industriyang panghimpapawid. Ayaw na natin mangyari ang ganitong trahedya sa kahit kanino. Wala ni sino man sa atin ang gugustuhin mawalan ng magulang, ng anak o ng kaibigan dahil lamang sa katamaran, pagkukulang o panlalamang ng iba. Higit sa luhat pagluluksa, higit sa mga parangal at pagkilala. Tiyak pong mas makabuluhan at mas gugustuhin ni Jesse kung may matututuhan tayo sa trahedyang sinapit niya. Huwag nating hayaan na mapunta sa wala ang kanyang pagkawala. Naway manatiling bukal ng inspirasyon ang alaala ni Jesse upang ang mga katangiang araw-araw na gumabay sa kanya, pagpapakumbaba, tapat na paglilingkod, malasakit sa kapwa ay saring manahin at sumalamin sa patuloy nating pagkilos bilang isang bansa. Ganda nga po, maraming salamat.
Thank you, Mr. President. May I now call on Secretary Joseph Emilio Abaya.
Magandang hapon po. Bago po ipakilala sa inyo yung chairman ng Special Investigation Committee, nais kong banggitin na kasama po natin dito sa hapong ito si Secretary Mar Rojas, siyang dating kalihim ng DOTC at siyang namuna ng search and rescue operation sa trahedyang itong nangyari kay Sec. Jesse. Kasama rin po natin si General William Hotchkiss, ang Director General ng CAAP. At pakilala ko na sa inyo ngayon si Captain Amado Soliman, ang Chairman ng Special Investigation Committee na siya magpapaliwanag at magpe-present ng findings ng kalang investigation. Captain Soliman.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. May I introduce the members of my board? We have Captain Pagiola, Vice Chairman, General Ramon Ragasa, representing the San Miguel Corporation and Philippine Airlines, Mr. Absyadi Abalos, representing Lufthansa, Captain Maynard Halili, representing the general aviation sector, Mr. Paul Quiballo, maintenance expert. On August 18, 2012, at around 3:07 in the afternoon, RPC 4431, a Piper Seneca, took off from Mactan, bound for Naga. On board were three passengers and one pilot. The weather was good and it was not a factor on the, as far as the accident was concerned. At about 4:25 in the afternoon of the same day, The Piper Seneca 4431 crashed into the waters of Masbate during the landing approach at approximately 800 meters from the shoreline of, or 1.11 kilometers from the runway 21 threshold of Masbate Airport. Next, please. The aircraft sank into the sea and only one occupant survived, while three perished. The aircraft was destroyed and written off. Accident Investigation Inquiry Board. These are been introduced. So you will see from Mactan, supposed to go to Naga, passing overhead Masbate. You see on the scale you have the Masbate runway. And when an aircraft is supposed to land on runway 21 of Masbate, there should be a parallel downwind to be followed by the pilot and then come in and land. But in this particular accident, anyway, we have used the 5M model approach to accident investigation. We have the mission, we have man, the medium, machine, and management. On this particular investigation, we considered man, machine, and management as the three M's that caused the accident. We disregarded the mission and media because the mission is a simple ferry flight from Mactan to Naga. And media, weather is good, the runway is properly prepared. So we only considered man, machine, and management. Man. The pilot is a 60-year-old and started his flying career in 1979, logged 6,536.35 minutes of flying time. On the Piper Seneca, for a period of 12 months, he has only flown for 17 hours and 54 minutes. He was rated on 17 types of aircraft, but was only current on 7. He is the owner, president, and CEO of Aviators Flying Incorporated, accountable officer, flight instructor of Aviators Flight School, director for operations, pilot of chartered and air taxi units. Next. The machine. The aircraft, a Piper Seneca PA-34-200 series, was manufactured in 1972. Aircraft was issued an export certificate of airworthiness by the US FAA on September 24, 2007, and was registered with the ATO, now the CAAP, on October 4, 2007. The aircraft has accumulated 10,000, as you see, hours, and last certificate was on November 14, 2011. Most recent 100 hours check was conducted by Aviators on August 10, 2012. Management. Aviators Management Organizational Setup. Captain Joseph Bahenting, President, CEO, and Aviators Incorporated, Accountable Officer, Flight Instructor of Aviators Flying School, Director of Operations, Pilot of Charter Air Taxi Unit. Captain Antonio Horidini, Director for Safety and Security for Aviators, School Director, Head of Training of the English the Flight School, Assistant Director for Operations for the Charter and Taxi Unit. Nelson Nepata, Director for Maintenance of Aviators and Taxi Unit, Chief Maintenance Inspector, Shop Manager for the Aviators Approved Maintenance Organization. Two recent accidents involving Aviators. Bourbon, Cebu, June 24, 2008. Bahenting himself survived a post-landing emergency. Fortunately, there were no injuries to person nor damage to the aircraft. Mambahaw, coming in, March 4, 2012, Cessna 172, RPC 209, crashed and killed 2 persons and injured 3. In this accident, student pilot signed as pilot in command. Result of this March 4 accident, the school underwent re-inspection and investigation with the following limitations: that no aircraft has to be that has been grounded shall be used for flight training, that aviators shall not accept new students, whether foreign or local, pending resolution of the case. Aviators shall continue to conduct ground and flight training for the students who are currently enrolled. Aviators shall strictly adhere, observe Philippine Civil Air Regulations and Republic Act 9497. Result. From Mactan to Masbate, Masbate, this is the flight path. Took off from Mactan at 3:07 in the afternoon. After 23 minutes, the first trouble was noticed. That they decided to go back to Mactan, but for whatever reason, he continued the flight instead of going back to Mactan. He flew for another 37 minutes towards Masbate. Then at that point, when he was 91 kilometers from Mactan, he lost his right engine. From there, he flew for another 17 minutes up to the time it crashed on 4:25 in the afternoon. Next. Findings on demand. No pre-flight briefing for passengers was conducted. Pilot have no previous experience on flight route to Masbate. Pilot lost situational awareness with regards to the plane's relative position to Masbate Airport. Pilot's license renewal did not cover one engine inoperative emergency during his proficiency flight. The decision to continue the flight to Nagai instead of immediately returning to Mactan after 23 minutes being airborne when propeller problem was first noted. Baka hindi tayo aabot ng propeller natin sa Naga, balik tayo sa Cebu. That was Captain Bainting being quoted. So, had he returned to Mactan at this point where he was only 23 minutes out of Mactan, he could have landed even with 2 engines still working. As the President has mentioned, I don't know what, he's the only person who is knowledgeable about his reason for continuing the flight instead of going back to Mactan. When the right engine became problematic, he continued to fly away from Cebu instead of, okay, that was already stated. Cebu has the most modern air navigation and communication equipment, the longest runway, the widest airstrip, the most advanced and most trained crash and fire rescue equipment and personnel within reach. Upon entering Masbate airspace, the pilot undertook improper approach procedures. Okay, flight approach heading pattern, premature extension of landing gears and flaps, improper approach maneuver. Next. So you have now, this is supposed to be your normal pattern when you're approaching for a landing on an airport, which is parallel to the runway azimuth. But in this particular flight, during the approach, after losing the engine, he tried to restart the engines 3 times, but he was not successful. Along that time, within a period of 50 seconds, he changed headings 5 times. And then finally, he settled on a heading of 345, and then made that as is supposed to be the downwind, which is not the required flight pattern. So in the process, he painted himself in a corner and overshot finals. So when he tried to recover from that overshooting finals, he plummeted down to the sea and crashed. The manual says that if you are not sure of reaching the airfield or the runway, you do not extend your landing gears, your flaps. And contrary to instructions also, you do not make stalls on a single engine because it will cause 500 loss of altitude and 15 degrees pitch angle. And this is what happened to the aircraft. This point here, which is 800 meters and 1.1 kilometers from the approach end of runway 21, is where the aircraft crashed. Conclusions. Accordingly, pilot error caused the crash. Captain Bainting improperly handled the one engine in operative emergency. Findings on the machine. The right-hand engine had experienced hard starting after installation of the overhauled propeller, but was never recorded in the aircraft logbook. The screws which hold the idler gear shaft in place experienced material failure. This is supposed to be the example of a healthy bolt. But you will see on the right side, you will see a dent on that, almost on the head, which is almost one third of the diameter of the bolt. And on the other side, the head of the bolt is no longer available. We were not able to discover this anymore after it was torn down. Next. This is the plate that's supposed to be hold those nuts in place. You see this folded corner to prevent the screw from turning. But sad to say, next. We'll go back. Can you go back to the sample of the bolt? Sad to say that this bolt are with so perforations where safety wires are supposed to be installed, but instead the plate was the one used. And you notice because of that wobbling and the looseness and the of the bolt, you had that severed portion, and this was causing the problem of by wobbling of the whole thing. next. This is supposed to be gear that's supposed to be installed on this thing, but if this thing is not properly stationed because of the screw that are defective, you will have this wobbling, and this plunger for the fuel supply will also not be properly actuated by this log, and you will have misfiring of the magnetos. You'll have fuel starvation, and the eventual result is the right engine conking out. Okay, next please. You see the right-hand engine crankcase. The crankshaft idler gear shaft stud is broken. As you see, there was no head. The crankshaft idler gear shaft screw is loose. The crankshaft idler gear shaft nut is missing. The crankshaft idler gear shaft mounting base is cross-threaded and elongated. The crankshaft idler gear shaft mounting guide bore is offset and elongated. So the left one is all right. Okay, next. The mounting bores, which were also offset, elongated, and cross-threaded. This condition is a manifestation of gradual material failure of the attaching screws and the mounting base holes, which indicated that the screw had been loose for a long period of time. The above conditions, the idler gear wobble, resulting to the erratic timing and misfiring of the magneto, which caused the engine vibration. The camshaft rotation also became irregular, and the fuel supply was insufficient, as the plunger for the fuel was intermittently failing, which resulted to the eventual failure of the engine. Stoppage of the right engine was the cause of the emergency. Remember, it's only the cause. The stoppage was likely caused by intermittent fuel supply and erratic engine firing. Intermittent fuel supply and erratic firing was caused by the parts failure due to the maintenance. Abitur was not certified by the aircraft manufacturer and accordingly by CAAP to conduct maintenance on that aircraft. Findings on the management. RPC 4431, not included in the Abitur's maintenance organization. Specific operating provisions for their mechanics were performing its maintenance. Five-day aircraft familiarization conducted, not in depth for the training. Maintenance personnel had inadequate training and skill to maintain the aircraft. Misdiagnosed the logbook remarks as sign of a propeller problem and sent the propeller for overhaul, even if the time before overhaul limit has not been reached. Entries of discrepancies and remarks actions not taken, not properly recorded in the aircraft logbook, and not in conformity with the regulatory requirements. Conclusion. The multiple and overlapping functions of each officer negated the system of checks and balances. This led to the bad maintenance practice, such as aviators performing maintenance functions on aircraft for which they were not certified. Other findings. Improper issuance of airworthiness certificate. On January 7, 2012, the test flight permit for renewal of the airworthiness certificate for RPC 4431 was approved by airworthiness inspector Fernando Avalos, the same person who inspected and recommended the issuance of the test flight permit. You see, this is a form that is supposed to be filled up by the inspector and approved by his superior. But in this case, he signed both. Next. There was no record or entry on the aircraft logbook for the test flight on January 7. A check with Mactan Cebu International Airport operations log revealed that no flight plan for RPC 4431 was filed on that day. Captain Federico Omalon III, flight instructor of Aviators and supposed pilot of the test flight, testified that Captain Bahinting asked him to sign the test flight report even though he did not fly the RPC 4431 on January 7, 2012. You see his certification. He is denying that he did not fly, but he was just made to sign. So there you are. These are evidences of collusion. Next. Okay, the January 17, 2012, application for airworthiness of renewal of RPC 4431 was signed and endorsed by, again, Fernando Avalos. On the same day, entry on the CASORT, Civil Aviation Safety Oversight Reporting and Tracking database, that the documents were required for airworthiness certificate renewal was likewise reviewed by Avalos again. February 2, 2012, the certificate of airworthiness for RPC 4431 with date of issue January 7, 2012 and date of expiration January 6, 2013 was released to Mr. Armand Gosum of Abitur's. January 7, 2012, inspection, issuance, and approval of test flight permit by Avalos, fictitious flight plan, flight by Captain Omalon. January 17, application for renewal of airworthiness certificate was signed and endorsed by Inspector Avalos again. Avalos also reviewed the supporting documents needed for the application. February 2, 2012, the certificate of airworthiness was released to Aviator's representative, but the date of issue on the certificate states 7 January 2012. The questionable issuance of pilot license. Incomplete fulfillment of pilot's proficiency test on the flight requirements. Captain Bahenting connived with Airworthiness Inspector Abalus to expedite the processing and approval of the Certificate of Airworthiness. Captain Bahenting Captain Bahenting received pilot's license notwithstanding questionable completion of the pilot proficiency flight test requirement. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Captain Soliman. That is the end of the presentation. But before we take questions, I'd like to call First Secretary Joseph Abaya again. The Secretary and also the Director General of CAAP, DG Hotchkiss, for the formal turnover of the report from the Special Investigating Body to the CAAP.
Director General Hotchkiss, I am submitting, sir, the accident report for RPC 4431, which was completed on 19 October 2012. Thank you very much.
Secretaries Abaya, Rojas, and the rest of the panel, as well as DG Hotchkiss, will now be ready to take your questions. Please state your name, your media agency, as well as the person that you are addressing the question to. Celerina, yes.
Good afternoon, Celerina Monte from the Daily Manila Shimbun. I don't know if this is for Secretary Abaya or to Director General Hotchkiss. What will happen to those personnel of the CAAP who allegedly connived with Avian Tours?
With the presentation of the report to me as CAAP Director General, I have caused the creation of a special investigating body to look into the culpabilities, administrative, criminal, whatever culpabilities there are, of the personnel involved, not just in CAAP, but also with those in Aviatur, the personnel involved there that led in the chain of events that led to this crash.
Sir, pending the investigation, are you going to suspend these officials, or they were already suspended?
Or what? Which one? Aviator has been suspended. It's full operation before, yeah. But not its personnel, not yet. We need to go through a due process thing. And regarding the investigating body, I have designated Assistant Director General Fajardo to look into this matter and present to me certain actions that have to be taken within 2 weeks' time.
But sir, I'm referring to the CAAP personnel. To the CAAP personnel who were allegedly in connivance. Will they be suspended, or they were suspended already, or what?
I will need a recommendation from Assistant Director General Fardo for me to be able to do this formally. And by tomorrow, we should have an action on that already.
Thank you.
The next question will be from Arya Kalika of the Philippine Star.
Sir, do you have the names of the CAAP or aviators officials who might be held liable for the plane crash?
Excuse me?
The names, sir. The names of the people who could be possibly held responsible for the plane crash. Aside from Mr. Abalos, who was mentioned in the report.
I'm sorry, I just didn't get the question.
Do you have the names, sir? Can we name the people or the personnel who would be investigated, aside from Mr. Abalos, who had been identified in the report?
Yes, the report of Captain Suleiman, all the names are there.
So it, yun na po yung lahat yun na mag-undergo.
Hindi lang po, hindi lang po ganun. Whatever is turned up by the investigating body will definitely also feel the brunt of the full implementation of Philippine Civil Air Regulation regulations.
And, can you give us an example of what they are possibly facing? The punishment that they are possibly
I guess we'll
facing.
Have to wait for the investigation to do that. We don't want to preempt due process, you know.
Thank you.
The next question will be coming from... Sorry. Yes, Florante Rosales.
Yes, Secretary Mar. Any reaction po dun sa nilabas po na result ngayon ng investigation now that the people know yung katotohanan sa nangyari?
Well, kinalulungkot ko na kabahagi bukod sa pilot error at saka materials failure at saka failure ng maintenance ng aviators na may kontsabahan, may pagsasabwatan sa pagitan ng nasirang Captain Bahinting at ang isang KAAP inspector. No? Kaya natutuwa naman ako na lalong pinapatibay ni Secretary Junabaya, ni General Hotchkiss, ang mga reforma na dapat na isagawa para matigil at lalong mapahigpit itong pagsubaybay, itong pagmamonitor ng lahat ng mga inspeksyon na sinasagawa ng gobyerno sa mga flying school at itong mga maliliit na flying operations. No? Sa puntong ito, gusto kong ulitin din yung sinabi ni Director General Hotchkiss na para sa ating mga manlalakbay sa panghimpapawid, no? Our air travelers, the commercial space is absolutely safe ayon sa kay Director General Hotchkiss, no? Ang mga patakaran, ang mga mekanismo, proseso na isinasagawa sa commercial airlines, sa mga malalaki kung saan yung mga nakakararami ng mga pasahero na sumasakay na isinasagawa ng KAAP ay mas mahigpit kaysa sa nakita natin dito sa mga maliliit sa flying school at saka sa small charter operations. No? Kaya malungkot man ang kinalabasan nitong aksidenteng ito ay patuloy na nanatiling ligtas ang paglalakbay sa panghihimpapawid, lalong-lalo na sa commercial aviation. Thank you.
Tere Andrada, GMA News.
First, Secretary Abaya. Sir, following the release of the report, ano na po ang gagawin action ng DOTC? Doon po sa mga flying schools, magkakaroon po ba ng audit or pag-check kung tama po ba yung mga pinapatupad nilang maintenance and kung sapat po ba yung mga materials and yung mga taong in charge dito? Thank you.
Well, unang-una, paliwanag ko sa ating mga kababayan na yung primary task talaga ng Special Investigation Committee na pinamunuan ni Captain Soliman, ang mission niya ay malaman, no, fact-finding, at para hindi maulit yung trahedya. Wala siyang mission na alamin ang culpabilidad o liability, whether criminal or administrative. Yan po ay pupunta sa KAAP. Kaya itong turnover ng investigation report sa KAAP, ngayon ay bubuo rin ng investigating team, si Director General Hotchkiss, para i-determine ngayon kung sino ang personal in KAAP and likewise outside of KAAP ang may liability, whether criminal or administrative. Mula sa DOTC, tingin ko dapat talaga pag-aralan ang pangkasalukuyang polisiya na hindi na po pwede yung dating gawi. Dapat dagdagan ang ating procedures para itong pagkukutsaba ay malimitahan, para yung regulations na nandyan naman lahat, ang naging kakulangan natin yung tamang implementasyon at pagsusunod sa tamang procedure. So, nandiyan po ang pulisiya, paghihigpit ang kailangan, at siguraduhin lang na yung implementasyon ay talagang sinusunod at hindi po pinag-uusapan lamang sa malamig na lugar.
TJ Bergonio of the Philippine Daily Inquirer.
Hey, good afternoon, sir. Sir, just we've mentioned several errors by the pilot. What do you think is the major error committed by the pilot that, if not committed, could have saved the three other passengers?
Among airline pilots, single engine is just a routine maneuver. I don't know why in the general aviation there seems to be a problem. Even if you lose an engine in a twin or in a multi-engine aircraft, it doesn't have to end in an accident. But it will end in an accident if the pilot lacks the training to handle that aircraft during emergency situations like having lost one engine.
Sir, would it have helped if the pilot just turned back?
As I was saying, it could have gone back to Cebu and still landed with two engines because the engine conked out 37 minutes after the first indication of trouble. So he was only 23 minutes out of Mactan. He could have very well gone back to Mactan and land with two engines.
Sir, would we say this is a combination of, as you have mentioned, the flow in the pilot, in the machine, and in the management?
That's right. But mostly, it is the pilot's inability to control that aircraft on an emergency situation where he lost one engine.
All right. Sir, the President had earlier mentioned an audit of permits. We're talking of how many permits that are now being audited?
When an aircraft has been put up service status and inspection shall be completed by the maintenance, then to have that aircraft back to status, it has to be given a test flown, to be test flown, so you need a permit for test flight. But all these were only done on paper. They were not actually complied with.
Captain Baliola, would you ask the number of permits that you have to be audited?
Okay. Insofar as re-auditing the schools and the air taxi operators are concerned, we will be re-auditing about 39 pilot schools and 24 maintenance organizations. We will also be reviewing 21 air taxi operators. And insofar as the foreign maintenance organizations are concerned, we have 69 of these approved maintenance organizations, which are either servicing purely foreign operators and some local operators. And we also have 48 local air maintenance, approved maintenance organizations. So those are the organizations that the CAAP is presently re-auditing and will re-audit in the future.
All right, sir, thank you.
Do we have any more questions for the gentlemen of the board and the two secretaries? If none, that is the end of the briefing. Thank you very much and good afternoon.
CAAP Head William Hotchkiss, Secretary Maroas of the DILG and DOTC Secretary June Abaya answering questions from the media, but it was the report of Captain Amado Soliman, the CAAP head of the Accident Investigation and Inquiry Board that everybody listened to. Now, among the discoveries they made during their investigation on the pilot, the investigation showed that Captain Bainting had no previous experience on flying the route from Cebu to Naga. They were saying that had he returned to Mactan once they discovered, or he discovered, that there was some trouble with his engine, he would have landed with two engines still running. There was also premature release of the landing gear, and Captain Bainting did not follow the correct flight path. Captain Soliman actually saying that he changed headings five times. This led them to conclude that pilot error caused a crash and Captain Jessup Bainting improperly handled the emergency. Captain Suleiman also noted some inconsistencies on the management of Aviatours. Now, Aviatours is not certified to conduct maintenance on their own aircraft, and maintenance people were not properly trained. Their plane problems were not recorded, and there were multiple overlapping functions of officers bypassed the checks and balances of the system. Excuse me. It was also discovered that Aviatours received numerous certifications for airworthiness of planes, even though no test flights were made, or at the very least, there was no recorded test flights made for the certification for airworthiness of Aviatours planes. There was also something questionable with the issuance of the pilot's licenses. Captain Jessup Bainting is concluded to have connived with, or suspected to have connived with CAAP personnel, more specifically with an Inspector Abalos, to expedite the processing and approval of certificates and licenses. Earlier in the press con, it was President Aquino who opened the press conference, saying that 3 months have passed since the death of Secretary Jesse Robredo in that plane crash, and he was saddened and dismayed by the results as he discovered that there was maintenance faults, it was the fault of the pilot, and most especially there was some collusion between Captain Jessup Bainting's company Aviatours and some personnel of the cab. We'll give you more details as soon as they become available. Please keep it here on ANC. News Now is next.
At any hour.